Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody. Good to not see you. I can't see you. Good to be here. Good to be able to speak to you. I want to speak to you from Matthew 25. Matthew chapter 25, verse 14 through 30. But I'm only going to read first two verses. 14 and 15. But we will go through all of them. I'm going to read the first two to save some time. And verse 14, starting with verse 14, it says, "For the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling to a far country who called his own servants and delivered his goods to them. And to one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1. To each according to his own ability, and immediately he went on a journey." Amen. I would like to use for our subject today is expectations. God has given you abilities and gifted you. You have talent and you have know-how. You've been given God-fearing people, God-loving people, willing and able to assist. That is resources. He's giving you resources. You've been put in places and positions, and all undeservingly so, but all with expectations. Anytime someone, even God, when he does something for you, he gives you something, there's expectations placed on you. An expectation that you would glorify God, honor the Father, and add to and not take away from the kingdom. Amen. Today's text is a familiar one. It's one of the parables of Jesus, the parable of the talents, or the story of the talents. And it's a true story. And I say it's a true story because Jesus cannot lie. Right? The Bible says, "Thou shalt not lie." Jesus lived a sinless life. So, therefore, whenever Jesus spoke a parable, it's a true story. Amen. But a parable is a short story to illustrate a spiritual or moral lesson. That's what a parable is. It was a tool. But what we need to know when it comes to expectations is who we are, what we possess, and what we've been given. Right? Who we are, what we possess, and what we've been given. So knowing who we are allows us to know what we possess. If you don't know yourself, you don't know what abilities you possess. If you just go through life, you know, just doing what comes up, you may never figure out what you possess. There are people who do things and display talents. And the question is, how in the world did you figure out you could do that? You know, contortionists, twisting their bodies up, and how did you know you could, how you find out you could do that? But we have to know ourselves and what we possess, right? We have to know who we are and what we possess. We have to know what we've been given. Verse 14 says, "The kingdom of heaven is like," true story, "a man traveling to a far country who called his own servants and delivered his goods to them," right? And he's going on a journey, but he called his own servants and delivered his goods to them. In other words, he entrusted his wealth to them. Much like God creating the earth and then giving man dominion over it. The next few verses tell us what was given to each servant and what they did with it, so we can look and see if they knew who they were, They knew what they possessed, and they understood what they were given. Right? This is, you know, what we need to know about expectations. In verse 15, it says, and to one was given 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1, to each according to his own ability. And immediately he went on a journey. To each according to his own ability. So, not only here do we need to know who we are, but this is saying that the master knows who we are. The master knows what we possess. We need to know what we possess. We need to know our ability, what abilities we have, what abilities we don't have. But the master knows. You don't possess a love for God's word just so that you could read it and know what it says. You don't have a love for God's word so that you can read it and feel good about yourself because you read it. That love for God's word is in your possession because he also gave you an ability maybe to write. So you should be writing books, songs, poems, study guides or manuals. You know, maybe your ability is in the area of influence. And so you need to take your love for God's word and preach or teach or motivate and inspire, encourage someone or empower or even counsel someone so that the kingdom can be enhanced, that you will add to the kingdom. And some of us are doing just that, but we should all put our abilities in motion. We should all be doing that because we have all been given to, and we all have expectations placed upon us, right? Verse 16, then he who had received the 5 talents went and traded with them and made another five talents. And likewise, he who had received the 2 gained 2 more also. But he who had received 1 went and dug in the ground and hid his Lord's money. After a long time, the Lord of those servants came and settled accounts with them. So we see here, the servants are utilizing their ability. First 2 went out and they doubled the money. They used their ability to double the money. The first one had 5, ended up with 10. The second one had 2, ended up with 4. And the third one used his time, his ability to dig. He buried the money. And if I hadn't known the story and I'm reading, I would think, why would the master give you talent to safeguard or to hold? You know, he could do that himself, or, you know, he could put it in a safe place himself. Why would he ask you? And then why would he only ask you to bury 1 bag if that's what he wanted? He gave 5 to one servant and 2 to another servant. That's 7 bags, and you have the 8th bag. And he's going on a journey, which means he probably has more bags. But after a long time, the Lord of those servants came and settled accounts with them. So he was coming back. He knew them. They knew him. They were his servants. They knew he was coming back. First 2 went to work, doubling the money. The third one went to work, burying the money. Do they really know themselves? First 2 seemed to know themselves. They didn't have any problems. They went and doubled the money. They knew what they can do. They went and did what they knew they can do. The third one, He did something he knew he could do. He buried the money. He knew he could do that. Now, I know I could do that. I couldn't do that. I like spending money, so there's no way I'm going to bury it. I can spend money. I have the ability to always be broke. I have that ability because I could spend every dime that I get. I can do that. But is that what the master, is that what God allowed me to have this job and this income to do? So I know me. I know what I possess. I know my abilities as far as money goes. And these talents are money. Actually, talents are bags of gold. So the first servant received 5 bags of gold. And the second received 2 bags of gold. And the third received a bag of gold. And the master gave them these bags according to their ability. So the first one had the ability to handle or do with 5 bags of gold what the second one can do with 2 and what the third one can do with 1. But they all had the ability to do what was expected of them, because that's what Jesus said. They all have the ability to do what was expected of them. We all have the ability to do what's expected of us, because God only gives to us according to our ability. He won't put more on you than you can bear. That's what that is. But he's coming back. We know he's coming back. The word says he's coming back. These servants knew their master was coming back because they knew him. They know, and he knew them. God knows us. He's told us he's coming back, and we have to be ready when he's coming back, because he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle. We have to be ready. So what we need to know when it comes to expectation is we have to know ourselves. We have to know what we are, what we possess as far as abilities. When we have to know what we've been given in order to use those abilities in accordance to what we've been given to meet the expectations placed upon us. We have to know ourselves. We have to know our abilities. We have to know what we've been given. What we need to know when it comes to expectations is who is expecting results. Who has put the expectations on us? Who did the giving? Knowing who will allow you to also know what is expected. Because expectations differ with who's expecting. But let me say, there are no expectations without consequences or repercussions. When something is expected and what's expected doesn't occur, you can expect repercussions. You can expect pushback, penalties, conversation, or something as a result. It all depends on the who. And when something is expected and what's expected does occur, you can still expect repercussions, because repercussions aren't only a negative thing. They can be positive and negative, just like consequences can be positive and negative, right? And you can do a positive thing, get a negative repercussion or response. You can do a positive thing and it have a negative consequence. When you do what's expected, the repercussions can come in the form of rewards, recognitions, maybe gifts, and more responsibilities, which could be a positive or a negative thing in itself. But there's always consequences, repercussions to us meeting the expectations or not. Verse 20 says, "So he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, 'Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents besides them.' His Lord said to him, 'Well done, good and faithful servant. you were faithful over a few things, I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. He also, who had received 2 talents, came and said, Lord, you delivered to me 2 talents. Look, I have gained 2 more talents besides them. His Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Then he who had received the 1 talent came and said, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered seed. And I was afraid and went and hid your talent in the ground. Look, there you have what is yours. But his Lord answered and said to him, you wicked and lazy servant. You knew that I reap where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. So you ought to have deposited my money with the bankers, and at my coming I would have received my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. And so we see here that there were expectations. We see that. We said that. There are our expectations when someone gives you something, when they do something for you. There's expectations. When you give someone money, you expect them to spend it. And if you gave them money for a certain reason, you expect them to spend it on that reason, to utilize it for that specific reason. Right? There are expectations. And if I give you a sandwich, I expect you to eat it. If you give me a sandwich, I'm going to eat it. But when she gets pregnant, the expectation is she's going to have a baby. And when she has the baby, the expectation is she's going to raise that baby. And so on and so forth. Expectation. So we have to know ourselves, what we possess, what we've been given. We have to know who's placed the expectation, who's done the giving. When we find those answers, we know we can figure out what's expected if those things have not been expressed. And in our text today, the expectation was not expressed. But we see that they knew the master, so they knew what was expected. God the Father sacrificed his son. The Son sacrificed his life so that we could have life, so that we could have abundance, be free. Verse 29 says, for to everyone who has, more will be given. For to everyone who has, more will be given, and he will have abundance. So to everyone who has Jesus, more will be given. And he will have abundance. Exactly what Jesus came and died, went to the cross for us to have abundance of life. But from him who does not have, even what he has will be taken away. But from him who does not have Christ, what he has will be taken away. From him who does not have everlasting life, he who does not have salvation, he who does not have Christ, even what he has, the life he has, will be taken away. Verse 30 says, and cast the unprofitable servant into the outer darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. And cast the unprofitable servant into the outer darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. You may not believe this, but it's right there. It's right there. Just because you're a servant, just because you consider yourself a servant, just because you act like a servant, doesn't mean you're profitable for the kingdom. Doesn't mean you're enhancing the kingdom. Doesn't mean you're adding to the kingdom. The work of the servant is just that. There's work. There's something for you to do. There are expectations for you to meet. And if those expectations are not met, repercussions and consequences will ensue. It's right there in the text. And the thing that God has given you, the life that Jesus has provided for you, the abundance, the freedom, you have the ability to accept, you have the ability to live out those things, you have the ability to meet the expectations placed on you because you accepted those things. The expectation for you to glorify God. The expectation for you to honor the Father, our Father which is in heaven. The expectation for you to love your neighbor as you love yourself. Pray for your enemies, and though they spite you, all of these things, you have the ability to do these things. And if you don't do these things, if you don't meet the expectation placed on you, then you will be a servant who is cast into the outer darkness. And there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. We have to know who the Master is so that the Master can give to us, and then we know what to do. We know what the expectations are. We don't know him. We're not going to know what the expectations are. You may not even know what he's giving us. What are you giving me? What is this for? So many of us are asking that question. What is this? What have you given me this for? What have you given me this yearning, this burning in my heart? Why have you given me this? Why do I feel like I want to help the entire world? Why do I feel this way? If you don't know the Master, you're not going to know what you've been given. You're not going to be able to use your ability to meet the expectation. Get to know God. You will know what he's given you. Then you will know what abilities you have so that you can utilize them to meet his expectation. God bless you.
Hello, I am Senior Pastor G.W. Gore at the Word of God Christian Ministries. And today we heard an awesome word from our assistant pastor, Minister Jerry Adams. So today I'm standing in once again for him as our gospel DJ. So as I always say, get up out of your seat, stand up on your feet, and give God an awesome praise. Today we're featuring our artist, Hezekiah Walker, and the song is Let's Dance. This for all my praises that like to dance.
In the world, everybody getting jiggy with it. Bad boy might say P. Diddy did it. The media really ain't trying to make it a hit. Break a gospel that ain't really legit. But on the real, if you really been following it, eat the word, seek the word, wallow in it. Praise will keep the lifelong winner in it. Now let's dance, show you'll be remembering it.
If you came to the praise party, then you can't leave the same way that you came in.
Come on.
Tell them what you want, you can have if you want to be free from sin. It's never too late if you want to celebrate in the body of Christ like me. You better get it while the getting is good. You can have it if you grab it while the getting is free.
Come on, let's dance.
Get up with me. Stand up on your feet.
Move out my way.
Move out my way. Got the praise today.
Lift your voice.
Lift your voice. Saints, make some noise.
Raise up.
Raise your hand. Move your feet. Let's dance.
Come on, let's dance.
Doesn't matter what color you're my brother. If you can be. Let me take you to a level.
You said it don't matter what color. You're my brother.
He comes that you might have life and that you might have it abundantly. You better get it while the getting is good. You can have it if you grab it while the getting is free.
Come on, let's dance.
Get up with me. Stand up on your feet.
Come on, y'all. Get up with me. Stand up on your feet. Man, Dave Hollister, this is my jam.
Oh,
Here we go. Here we go. For all you rapping lovers, let me hear you.
And I'm bitch, trying to prove of the saints of God, kid. Now if you wanted it, it could be like that. Ain't no payment on the baby, it'd be free like that. Don't be blurring up your vision, you can see like that. Now welcome to the brotherhood dance.
Come on, so, come on. Babe, get up with me. Stand up on your feet.
Move out of my way.
Move out my way. Got the grace to get.
Turn it into your voice now.
Get your voice. Saints, make some noise.
Raise your hand.
Raise your hand. Move your feet. Let's dance.
Come on, come on.
Babe, get up.
Listen, this next one is my man J Moss featuring Hezekiah Walker. I love this cat. If we need somebody to get a prayer through, the Bible says that the prayers of the righteous avail much.
Can anybody out there pray for me without even knowing what I need? Can anybody out there pray for me? The prayers of the righteous. Can anybody out there pray for me without even knowing a whole lot about me? Can anybody pray where the prayer don't cease? The prayers of the righteous.
He looking for a soldier. Maybe a real friend.
I can't do it by myself.
Yeah, I heard him say it. He looking for a warrior. A real friend.
I can't do it by myself.
No,
should always pray.
Ancient prayer, that they will not fail.
Got any warriors out there? Come on, Hezekiah.
Yeah.
That was my man Hezekiah. Now this next one is a song that I really, really love to hear. It ministers to my spirit because it's biblically based. The song says Keeper, featuring Eric McDaniel.
Me deep. Lord, you pick me.
So listen. I'm Senior Pastor G.W. Gord, the Word of God Christian Ministries. And I hope you enjoyed this part of the service, and that you would allow these songs to minister to your spirit and the word that was brought forth today. Just remember, this week, I know we all have had some hard times that we've been dealing with a lot in these last few months. But remember, God is always in control. He is always the God, the creator, supreme ruler of heaven and earth. And there's nothing that has caught him by surprise. And he is a keeper of our soul. So as you listen to this song, remember that he is watching over you day and night. God bless.